So you don't need 1,000 followers or 10,000 followers or even a stream key to be able to go ahead and stream vertically to TikTok to help you grow your stream. So the first way to be able to do this, and there's two methods. The first is utilizing Streamlabs. So Streamlabs is now connected over to TikTok, allowing you to be able to stream from Streamlabs vertically to TikTok without a stream key. There is an application process, but I'm going to show you the easiest way to be able to get approved. And again, it may take 24 to 48 hours, sometimes even a week, to gain access, and sometimes it may get declined. But however, here's an opportunity for you to be able to do this. So you'll open up Streamlabs desktop. You'll want to make sure that you'll get logged in with your TikTok account here at the bottom. So once you click that, you'll select yes, get logged in with your TikTok account. And then what you want to do is you want to come to settings. You want to come to where it says here video. You want to make sure you enable dual output and make sure that that's on. You hit done, and now you have a horizontal and a vertical output. You then simply just want to go ahead and hit go live. And I know we don't have anything set right now, but this is just to begin the application process. So you'll select go live anyway. And here you're going to see here that you're going to see your TikTok, and it's going to say apply for TikTok live permission. So you'll go ahead and select that there. Once you select that, that's going to bring you to a page just like this. It's going to say get live access on Streamlabs. Now it's going to say live on Streamlabs, no access. You simply want to select apply. And when you select apply here, it's going to go ahead and ask you to go ahead and input a certain information here. So we'll select your channel. So you can select here the channel that you stream to the most. So if you stream mostly to Twitch, you want to put Twitch. If you stream mostly to YouTube, you want to put YouTube, Kick, Meta. These are the platforms you want to put on here. So let's say, for example, I use Twitch. You simply want to enter your Twitch URL here. And the easiest way to be able to get that is to go to twitch.tv, go to your channel. And once you're on your channel, you'll see the link here at the top. We'll come back here. You'll paste that link there. And then it's going to ask you, what is the average concurrent viewer that you normally get? And again, if you put 500, 400, 50, doesn't matter. You want to make sure this is as realistic as it possibly can. So if you get less than 10, go ahead and put less than 10. If you get more than 10, put more than 10. So I'll select here 10 plus. And then it's going to provide you to select three screenshots to verify that you're the account holder. So the three screenshots that I've used to go ahead and get approved, the first one was just taking a screenshot of my channel that has my name, my followers, and just shows that I stream. That's going to be the first screenshot that I would go ahead and upload. The second screenshot that I would upload is going to be inside of your creator dashboard. I would come to analytics, come to overview, and then I would go ahead and capture this information that I have here. And then the last one that you can go ahead and input would can be here on your home, and you can just share your homepage where it says your name, says everything in here, and you can go ahead and display that information there. So I would go ahead and upload those three screenshots. And I'm just going to go ahead and select one here for the time being. Let's just go ahead and select that. I'm going to say this is the screenshot that I'm going to utilize. So I'm going to come to overview. I'm going to select this. And now I'm just going to go ahead and upload this at this moment. So I'm going to go to desktop and we'll grab the screenshot. And now once you submit that, you'll simply go ahead and hit submit. And now you're going to see here, it's going to say the channel's already linked because I already used it. And then you're going to see a screenshot that's going to say waiting for approval. And then once you get approved, it'll come to a screenshot just like this. It says live on Streamlabs approved. Say congrats, you now have access to live stream. All good. And then once you've gone ahead and gotten approved, again, it may take 24 to 48 hours, sometimes a week. You may even get declined. You may just have to reapply over and over again until you get access. But once you do, you'll get logged. You get logged in for your account. You'll simply go live anyways. And now what you'll see here is that there's no more an option to be applied. We just simply have to put our title, no stream key required, and then we'll confirm and go live, and that will send us over live over to TikTok without a stream key here in a horizontal and vertical format. So that's going to be the easiest way to be able to go ahead and get your stream key. The second method to be able to go ahead and do this is to apply directly through TikTok. And you don't need 1,000 subscribers or 1,000 followers either, but you apply directly through TikTok. And what this is going to give you access to is going to give you access to the TikTok Live Studio to be able to go ahead and live stream directly, but you won't be able to utilize OBS or you won't be able to utilize Streamlabs utilizing that method. This method that I show you here with Streamlabs is going to be the more surefire way to get access. So attempt that way. And now if you want to learn how to go ahead and set up overlays for your Streamlabs account to make your stream look professional, go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step by step on doing just that. I'll see you guys in the next video.